Okay, this is part two. This is our snake qigong, which we've been working for a couple of weeks. So don't forget the movements, and I'm going to introduce the final movement, which is an easy one. It's just the hands, and we work plenty of that in class as well, so you should be okay. So,
Sorry, the sun. I don't know if I can see you for the sun. Okay, do you want to move back a little bit, please? Yeah, okay. That's much better.
And up, enter, turn back. Try and keep the rotation nice and slow. Push up with the arms. And feel free to do more than what I'm doing here. Going into the second rotation, which is a push alongside the body and arc up and away. And then the opposite, so arc down, scoop up. Don't be afraid to stretch and be quite loose, so try and relax your body as much as possible when you're doing these. Going the other way. Down, opening the feet, sink, cross, over, peek through the window, and go again. From here we're going to turn, put the arms in contact, keep them in contact, all the way through. Take a yoga mat if your knees are sensitive. Final movement is very close to some of the ones we've been doing in class, like this, or like this, but it looks like that. One way, the other way, and switch. This is a full body movement. You can light swap the hands over. Don't forget to move the hips. Swap the rotation. And that completes your four first snake movements.